Since 1949, Archbishop Riordan High School has been preparing young men for leadership and lifelong success through a rigorous college preparatory curriculum while instilling Catholic Marianist values. The graduating class of 2020 also became Riordan's final all-male class because after 71 years, Riordan will begin accepting female students this fall. The new graduates, including Philippine Consul General Henry Benserzo Jr.'s son, Henry Matthew, talked about being part of the last all-male high school in San Francisco.
It was really fun. I don't think I would have the same experience at any other school because you got like the brotherhood around, and it was you got people like theater nerds, band geeks, you got the jocks, dorm students, and then they all still come together.
Meanwhile, Mercy High School, San Francisco, an all-girls Catholic institution for 68 years, closed its doors in June due to financial hardships brought about by drops in enrollment, lack of funding, increased operational costs, and the rising cost of living. Trying to prevent a similar outcome in Riordan, school officials decided to open its doors to female students. Philam Alex Daytalk from the class of 1987 is Riordan's director of campus ministry. His son Jameson will be returning to Riordan next fall as a sophomore. He has mixed feelings of the school turning co-ed, but says he understands why it happened.
I just saw this as an opportunity to keep Riordan alive, and an exciting time for us to put our best foot forward and educate young women. As an alum and as a parent, I was kind of saddened, but as an employee, I'm excited for the new opportunity coming.
For Henry Matthew, amid the changes, he's confident Riordan's spirit of camaraderie will continue.
Like the boys would have their own culture, and then the girls would have their own culture, if that makes sense. You know, like probably mix together once the school year comes around.
For the 2020-2021 school year, Riordan will see its largest student body in 35 years with 820 students, 22% of whom are females. It remains to be seen how the ongoing pandemic will affect Riordan's mode of learning when school starts in mid-August. San Francisco officials are recommending distant learning from almost all students, while a select few may be able to do in-person schooling. Once the outbreak is more contained, city officials say there will be a gradual return to a mix of distant and in-person learning. Ramon Kinclair, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.